Okay, I know that saying something looks like a drug hallucination or a fever dream is pretty cliche these days, but I honestly can't think of a better way to describe today's video game of choice. Snaxon Jaxson. I mean, just look at this thing! What kind of mind frame or clown-related accident do you have to be in to create something like this? This game gave me nightmares when I was a child. And, to be honest, I still find it quite unsettling as an adult. But frightening visuals aside, let's talk about this game. In the game, you play as a clown, of the hobo variety, who has some strange disorders. One being his tendency to sneeze off his own nose. And I mean that literally. That's not a fake rubber nose he's wearing, it's his actual nose. To prove this further, you can actually see his nose hole on his face after he sneezes. Which is kinda gory for a video game that came out in 1984. To make matters weirder, he can only eat food while his nose is off. The other disorder he has is the ability to stretch his elastic neck as far as he needs to eat said food. These disorders provide the gameplay for this game. The game starts with Jaxson sneezing his own nose off, then food comes out and he has to eat all the food on the screen and then bounce his nose, like one of those high bounce balls you used to find in gumball machines. You know, the ones you used to mistake for gum as a kid and then get really disappointed that it wasn't gum, because it tasted like rubber shit. Anyways, if you miss the ball, it will break one of the windows behind you, causing you to lose a life. If you bounce the ball without eating all the food displayed, a little gremlin guy comes out and hits you with a pie, causing you to lose a life. Why? Because getting a pie to the face is the ultimate insult to a clown. It's like telling him his mother was so white they couldn't tell when she was wearing face paint. How could this happen to me? I made my mistakes. Once you've succeeded at eating food and bouncing his nose 6 times, Jaxson's nose will reattach to his face and you can proceed to the next level. And he seems pretty happy about it. Either he's happy he doesn't need surgery to reattach it, or he's in the process of going mad. I'm voting for the latter. So now that I've explained the gameplay, you might be happy to know that the way they spelled Jaxson's name isn't some way to be hip or gangster, because, I mean, look at him. It's instead a clever pun that partially explains the fact that the gameplay is based on the old children's game, Jax. However, since no one's played Jax since, I don't know, the 50s, I'll try to explain the game to the best of my ability. You lay down these spiky things called Jax, you then bounce a rubber ball and grab the Jax. If your friend tells you you cheated, you tell him that he doesn't know Jack. Then you challenge him to Mortal Kombat where you kick his ass with Jax, followed by eating dinner at Jack in the Box, and following that up with some Cracker Jacks, then going home so that you can jack into the internet, to which you'll look at porn and jack off. That's Jax. Seems pretty complicated to me. Good thing we have video games these days. Now as the game continues, it raises the difficulty not only by adding more food between bounces, but also having the little green guy come out and actually try to sabotage your balanced diet by throwing things out like jalapenos and bars of soap. Eating either of those items will temporarily stun Jaxson, making it harder for him to eat all the food and bounce the ball in time. Fortunately, Jaxson has defense for this. You can press a button to make Jaxson sneeze and it'll blow away any peppers or soap on the screen. Considering that he's sneezing without a nose, that makes his mode of defense pretty disgusting to say the least. But hey, at least it's effective. So what is this little green guy anyways? It looks like the love child of Peter Pepper from Burger Time and the Lady Gremlin from Gremlins 2. And what's his deal? Since he's a chef, I assume he's the one feeding you. But if that is the case, why is he sabotaging your meal with soap and jalapenos? What is his purpose? These things need to be answered, and yet none are provided. But we must know the answers are out there.
What you're about to see is not a news broadcast.
Today on Unsolved Mysteries, we investigate this guy. What is he? Why is he so small? Why is he green? Is he a gamma-radiated cook smurf? Maybe you can solve the mystery.
So this game takes place over 4 meals, each having you eat food items that relate to that meal. The meals are breakfast. Hey, you, stop waffling! Lunch, where Jaxson eats corn on the cob, and by that I mean the entire thing, cob and all. Dinner, where there's a lot at stake. Eh? And finally, Midnight Snack, which isn't a meal, and by far the creepiest level. I mean, look at this! It's the exact same room as the other levels! He's just converted the table to a bed so he could sleep! This is some fucked up shit! I mean, look how claustrophobic this is! There's like nowhere to move at all! No doors, closed-in walls, the windows are too small to escape. Jaxson is trapped here.
Forever.
Destined to do nothing but sneeze his nose off and eat while being tortured by gremlins. This is clown hell, and we get to witness it.
Oh my God!
The only positive I can say to this experience is, well, at least hell has Hostess cupcakes. Seriously, that's what they are. Now, to vary things up a bit, there are bonus levels between each meal that gives you a chance to earn some extra points. Bonus levels include one where you have to see how many times you can consistently bounce your nose. The next one has you bouncing baseballs with your face! Seems like I have a lot of balls! The third has you juggling three balls with your face. And the final one has you in an all-you-can-eat level. Needless to say, this game is nuts! Seemingly, this is all part of living a day in the life of Jaxson. Wow, I now have a new appreciation for my crappy life. Thank you, Snacks and Jaxson. Well, that's pretty much it for Snacks and Jaxson. And if you can get past all of the creepy imagery, it's actually a pretty cool game. Really fun to play, the controls work really well, and for 1984, the graphics are pretty impressive. Especially its ability to portray a 3D environment and make it easy to see where the nose ball is going to land thanks to a drop shadow. Even the music is actually pretty impressive for the time. So the question is, why is this game not successful? Why is it not as fondly remembered as Pac-Man, Galaga, or Joust? I'm going to say it's because of the imagery. Sure, good gameplay can make up for bad graphics, but here, it's not that they're bad, they're actually quite good. They're just unnerving, and just plain makes you feel uneasy. I mean, even when I was a kid, I wanted nothing to do with this game because it was so nightmarish to me. It's only playing it now as an adult that I'm able to admire it for what it is. A really creative, well-made game that's a lot of fun. So if you can get past the creepiness of the game, then I recommend giving it a try. It's a lot of fun. Just don't blame me if you have any nightmares afterwards. Thanks for watching the latest episode of Arcade Funhouse. If you want to see another episode from me, click on the box to see my review of Ninja Clowns. A title that's only half correct. See ya!